So, ordering the believers to lower min al-salah from the deen. This is by the mercy of Allah, because as he mentioned in Sunday rahimahullah, that when it came the order to protect their parts, their private parts, it was to protect it, to completely have chastity. But when it comes to the eyes, they might have to see, like the witness in front of the judge. They have to know who's that person. So it's permissible to see the face of the woman in that case, to make sure that it's that specific person. Or al-khatib, or when someone wants to get married, that he would see the one that he wants to marry, and she would see his face, and so on. But in general, it's haram, everything else. That means they have to lower their gaze from all of the women that are strangers to them, not mahram. And the same thing as a second separate verse is mentioned for men, and separate verse is mentioned for women. This is how clear the ayat. Right? Linguistically, you can say, if it says كل المؤمنين غضوا من أبصارهم, say to the believers, right, to lower their gaze, that would include the women also. Because it doesn't have to be mentioned men and women, because the rulings are the same. But see how the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made the rulings very clear. The next verse, وَقُلْ لِلْمُؤْمِنَاتِ, and say to the believing women, يَغْضُضْنَ مِنْ أَبْصَارِهِمْ, also to lower their gaze when it comes to the awrat, to the men and so on. Right? وَيَحْفَظُوا فُرُوجَهُمْ. Hifz al-fard, al-fard is the private part, to be ordered to be protected, right, period. But when it comes to lowering the gaze, as we said. So this is one of the steps of the shaitan, and it's haram for the people to look at what is forbidden for them to see. وَقُلِ الْمُؤْمِنَاتِ يَغْضُضْنَ مِنْ أَبْصَارِهِنَّ وَيَحْفَظْنَ فُرُوجَهُنَّ, then وَلَا يُبْدِينَ زِينَتَهُنَّ إِلَّا مَا ظَهَرَ مِنْهَا, not to show their zina, right, except what has to show from it, right? إِلَّا مَا ظَهَرَ مِنْهَا, right? Some said it's the face and the hands, as Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu, he said. And some said it's the outside garment that has, you know, they cannot hide it anyway because it has to show. And that's where the issue with whether it's showing the face or covering the face, which is a valid difference of opinions among the ulama, but we have to be careful. Because yes, when it comes to a matter of mas'ala and matters of fiqh, yes, there is a difference of opinions about this matter. But you would find those ulama that would take the opinion that it's permissible for the women to show their face, right? They would make sure that their wives are covered, for the most part, their faces. And they would do this because there's a level of knowing the rule of it and knowing also the virtue of what is being or to be covered, plus the matter has differences of opinions anyway, but it's not permissible for them to look at one another. And plus, if the fusat of people of evil are widespread in a place, then the woman should cover her face, it becomes mandatory for her, so that nobody would see her. Or if she is, as those who said it's permissible to show, but if she is, her face is, you know, attracting the eyes of others or whatever there is, then it should be covered. So this is an ayah about hijab, and the ayah of Surah Al-Ahzab makes it more clear about covering the face. But so there's the ayah of Surah An-nur and there's the ayah of Surah Al-Ahzab. وَلِيَضْرِبْنَ بِخُمُرِهِنَّ عَلَى جُنُوبِهِنَّ, and to bring the khimar. And the khimar, right, is very clear also, which is comes from, even the word al-khamr comes from it. Khamr is khamr because it covers the minds of a person. So al-khimar is what covers, right, and it comes down from their heads, and this is mentioned also in Surah Al-Ahzab clearly, عَلَى جُيُوبِهِمْ. Al-jayb is the opening of the garment that the woman wears from the neck, like the V-neck. So it comes down to cover this, right? So this is to come down. That means it's not to be covering and that's it. No, she has to wear the khimar. So the woman, she has to wear the khimar, and the khimar comes down to cover this. So therefore, it's not permissible for her to shape her shoulders, because she has to have a khimar that covers this. This is also, many women, they don't pay attention to that. They think as long as she's covered, so she's wearing the abaya, and it's like this, right? And she has the thing tucked in, that's not permissible. Your body is shown, is shaped. Supposed to wear a khimar that comes down, and this is covers her shoulder. It's not shaping her body. وَلْيَضْرِبْنَ بِخُمُرِهِنَّ عَلَى جُمْبِهِنَّ وَلَا يُبْدِينَ زِينَتَهُنَّ, and not to expose the zina, the adornment, except, and these are the maharim that are mentioned clearly in the verse, إِلَّا لِبُغُولَتِهِنَّ, her husbands, أَوْ أَبَائِهِنَّ, or their fathers, or أَبَائِ بُغُولَتِهِنَّ, or the fathers of their husbands, أَوْ أَبْنَائِهِنَّ, or their daughters, or their sons, أَوْ أَبْنَائِ بُغُولَتِهِنَّ, or the sons of their husbands, step sons of their husbands. أو إخوانهم, or their brothers, or بني إخوانهم, or the sons of their brothers, أو بني أخواتهم, or the sons of their sisters, أو نسائهم, or the women, and نسائهم here refers to the Muslim women, and that's why نسائهم, right? So that's why this is a delil for those who said that if it's a non-Muslim, then it's not permissible to see the Muslim. Or if it sees, it only sees what is, the normal, which is, and that's even with the sons and so on. What does these people see from the woman? Her father, except the husband, of course, the father of the husband and their son and so on, is to see what normally is shown from the woman when she's at home, which, as they say, the head with the hair, the neck. Some even said it very, very clearly. You want the criteria to this? What would usually show in her wudu? So she can make wudu in front of them. So what is shown from the woman when she makes wudu? Her face, her head, that means her hair, and her fingertips till her elbow. So this part, only till here. Right? And that's why, in front even of the sons and so on, it should be to the places where it shows in wudu, and her feet. And something little over there, which is also part of the wudu. But this is what can be shown. أَوْ مَا مَلَكَتْ أَيْمَنُونَ, and this is with the slaves. And there's two opinions in this. Some said the slave, that the woman, she has to cover in front of them. If she has a slave, is to be covered totally in front of him. And some said he can see from her what, as we said. But there's a difference of opinions about this. أو التابعين غيري, of course this is the only thing that is permissible, of course, it's not like the other way around. أو التابعين غيري إربة من الرجال, or those who have no desire in women, which is not, they have a physical issue, that means that they don't have any desire for women. أو التابعين غيري إربة من الرجال. And as he says here, كالمعتوه, as the crazy person, for example, or someone that lost his mind, or al-innin. Al-innin is the one that has no ability whatsoever, and he has no even means of this. أو الطفل الذين لم يظهروا على عورات النساء, or the child that الذين لم يظهروا على عورات النساء. That means they are children, that they're below the age where they can really see the women as in a desirable way. They don't have to have the desire, but they don't understand that yet. And it's a very obvious thing. The other child doesn't know these things, doesn't look like this. But a child can be 8 years old, right? He's not a responsible person yet. He did not reach the age of puberty, but he knows what's a beautiful, what's not a beautiful one. If he has this ability to differentiate, then he is not to see the woman, to stay away, to be with the men. So this can be a child in first grade, right? But he knows these things. He has an idea, he has an opinion about these matters, right? Then he is to be he does not go into the room. So that's why normally is 8, 9, these types of ages. In some situations it can be even younger, but usually the age of a tamiz where they start to be away from women, 7 and above. Now, tifli, الذين, so the child is permissible for him that she would be with what we said the norm is, but with the condition الذين لم يظهروا على عورات النساء. And the expression is very clear, يظهروا على عورات النساء. That means they don't know the عورات النساء, they don't know what it, or they don't have an opinion about it, they don't see it in such a way. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered the women, وَلَا يَضْرِبْنَا بِأَرْجُلِهِنَّ يُعْلَمْ مَا يَخْفِينَ مِنْ زِينَتِهِنَّ. And not to show the adornment or beauty even when they hit the ground with their foot, and the sound of the bracelets in their legs would show. Just to have a sound, it's something for them to cover and to conceal. وَتُوبُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا أَيُّهَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. And repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all of you, جَمِيعًا أَيُّهَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ, for whatever is mentioned in the verse and in general. If any of this is not observed, to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala so that you are successful. So we would see then that this is what is meant by the hijab, and it's concealing the beauty. The word zina is mentioned. So any beauty, when it shows, that this is haram for it to be shown, and the people have to be patient with that and to return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Just one part, and that will stop, inshallah, if anybody wants me to do to raka'ah, is that the order from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to get those who they are in charge of, to get them married. This is the order from, this is one of the ways, this is the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, is for people to get married. With all of these rulings, right, people, if they think that this is making it strict for the people, yes, it's strict to do haram, so that the halal becomes at ease. But when then the problem is when the halal is difficult and the haram is easy, this is where it's fitna. So that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَأَنْكِحُوا الْأَيَامَ مِنْكُمُ الصَّالِحِينَ مِنْ عِبَادِكُمْ وَأَبْنَائِكُمْ. Get them married, those al-ayama, those the woman that has no husbands, and the righteous among your slaves and your slave people, to get them married. يَكُونُوا فُقَرَاءَ يُغْنِيهِمُ اللَّهُ فَضْلًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows this. What's the reason why many people, when they have the means to get married, they are not getting married? Is because they're poor. Or because the wali, the guardian of the woman, he wants him to be rich for him to accept him as a husband or whatever. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, if they are fuqara, if they are poor, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will enrich them from his bounty subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's why marriage is one of the means of getting rich, to have wealth is to get married. If you're poor, get married. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will provide for you. Of course, they have to have the necessity, they have to have a shelter. He's not going to marry someone and live in the street. So you have to have a shelter. He has to have also the means, if he can sustain his life, he can sustain someone else's life. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as long as he's righteous and he has the manners and so on, and he is someone that takes the means, because a person can be lazy or not taking the means or so on, then that's of course the responsibility for that person to be refused if he's going to ruin the one that is under his authority and so on. But if they have the means, but the poor is to get them married. And that's why he says, وَفِي حَثُّ عَلَى التَّزَوُّجِ وَوَعَدْ لِلْمُتَزَوُّجِ مِنْ غِنَى الْعَرْفِ. This is encouraging for people to get married, and to promise the ones that get married that he would get more wealth after being poor. That's why Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu said, how can someone hear this verse and doesn't get married? Because it increases your wealth, right? Allahu wasi'un alim. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wasi' is the one that encompasses everything. And he's the all-knower subhanahu wa ta'ala. His khayr is so much in abundance. And he's the one that provides for his slaves. But for those who are not able to get married, whether it's because they have no means, there's no righteous ones, right? They're not allowed to get married. Whatever the reason is, right? وَلْيَسْتَعْفِفِ الَّذِينَ لَا يَجِدُونَ نِكَحًا حَتَّى يُغْنِيَهُمُ اللَّهُ مِنْ فَضْلِهِ. وَلْيَسْتَعْفِفِ. The order from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for those who are not able to get married, they have to have iffah. They have to have chastity. They have to stay away from anything that is haram, whether it's not lowering their gaze and what's beyond that. وَلْيَسْتَعْفِفِ الَّذِينَ لَا يَجِدُونَ نِكَحًا حَتَّى يُغْنِيَهُمُ اللَّهُ مِنْ فَضْلِهِ. Till Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala suffice for them. So it also shows that for a person to be provided for, he has to have afif. And yasta'afif yu'afihullah. Whoever becomes afif, that he turns away from evil things and from what his even nafs is urging him to do, for the sake of Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will enrich him and protect him and provide for him. وَالَّذِينَ يَبْتَغُونَ الْكِتَابَ مِمَّا مَلَكَتْ أَيْمَانُكُمْ فَكَاتِبُوهُمْ إِنْ عَلِمْتُمْ فِيهِمْ خَيْرًا وَأْتُوهُمْ مِنْ بَيْنِ أَيْدِيهِمْ فَاعْلَمُوا Till, you know, other applicable matters and so on. We'll stop here inshallah ta'ala before the time, but of course there are many rulings and things like this, but it shows the many benefits, whether it's to protect one's deen and chastity and so on, and the order to get married and the methods of taking permissions and protecting and guarding one's tongue from slander and saying bad words against others. All of these are different rulings and more, inshallah ta'ala. And ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among those who listen and apply the orders of Allah. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.